These are some general purpose commands. So, the first command is date command. It displays the system date and time. The syntax is date, option, and format. Option and format, these two things are optional. The format controls the output. An option, the date command has such type of option. Date minus R will output date and time in RFC format. Date minus D will display the time described by the string. Date minus S will set the time described by the string. Date minus U will print or send coordinated universal time. These are the some format names. We can use any format name as per our requirement in the output. The next command is cal command. It displays the calendar for the current month. Syntax is cal option. First option is cal minus 1. This will display the single month output. Cal minus 3 will display previous, current and next month output. Cal minus S will display Sunday as the first day of the week. Cal minus M will display Monday as the first day of the week. Cal minus J will display the Julian dates. Cal minus Y will display the calendar for the current year. The next command is clear. This will clear the terminal screen. Syntax is clear. TTY, print a file name of the terminal connected to the standard output. The syntax is TTY. Script. This will make TypeScript of the terminal session. If the argument file is given, the script saves all the dialog in the file. If no file name is given, the TypeScript is saved in the file TypeScript. Syntax is script file name. So, the example is script file1. File1 is created. With minus A option, the file1 contents are appended. The next command is man. It gives the manual help for any command. Syntax is man and the name of the command for which we want the help. The basic commands. These are some basic commands in the Linux. First command is who. It is used to display who are the users connected to our computer currently. Syntax is who. Option. Minus A will display all the users who have been logged in currently. Minus B will display the time of the last system boot. Minus D will print the dead processes. Minus H will print the column heading. Minus L will print the system login processes. Who am I? It will display the details of currently working user. So, the syntax is who am I? Login. This command is used to switch from one user to another at any time. Syntax is login. Passwd. This command is used to set the password of the current user. It asks for entering the new password and then confirm password. Syntax is passwd. Next command is su. This command provides super user privileges. It will ask for a super user password. Syntax is su. Next command is pwd. It displays the present working directory. Syntax is.
So I have done the login as srb. So I will execute the command. So first date command is executed. So this will display the today's date. So first day name Monday is given, after that August, month name, and after that 17 is the date of today. This is the time of today and this is Indian Standard Time and the year. Okay, so we will use various option of date. So first minus capital R, so date minus capital R, this will give us the date in RFC format. Now I will use date with minus D option, so date minus D. Now here we can specify our string. So suppose I will give here today, so it will give us the date of today. Now suppose I want to display the date of tomorrow, so I will write the string as a tomorrow, so it will display the date of tomorrow. From here you can check that Tuesday, August, 18 August and the year. Okay, now suppose I want to check the date of yesterday, so I will write here the string as yesterday. So 16th August Sunday it has given, so this is the yesterday's date. Okay, now suppose I have written date with minus D option and written there as now, so it will display the today's date and the current time. Okay, now suppose I will write here 1 hour ago, so this will give me the time 1 hour ago. From here you can check that here is 4, now it is displaying 3. And suppose we want to check the time after 1 hour, so I will remove the word ago, so it will give me the time after 1 hour. Okay, now suppose I will write date minus D, after that 2 years month, suppose 4 month and day, suppose 1 day. So this will give me the date after 2 years, 4 month and day, 1 day. So 2 years means it has given 2022, 4 months means after August, December is the 4th month, and 1 day means Monday, and this is the, today is 17, so it has given 18. So the day is displayed there, Sunday. Okay, now in this way we can have any type of date to be displayed that we have specified in the string. Now we can set the date. For setting the date, we must be logged as a super user. So I will change my login using su command. So password of the super user I will write here. So now from this you can check that this is the normal SRB user, this is the root user, that is the super user, and here the prompt is dollar prompt for SRB, and for the root it is the hash prompt. Now suppose I will write here date, so it will display me the date, today's date that we have seen previously. And suppose I want to set the date, so I will write here date and minus s option, and here I have to write my string. So for string don't use the name of the day, okay, we will write from the month name. So suppose I want to set the date as a September, so ACP, after that suppose I will write here 18, after that suppose I will set the time as 7:30, so 30, after that IST and 2020. Suppose I will set in this way, so it will give us the setted date. Now suppose I will execute the date command, this date will be set. Okay, now from SRB user also we will get the same date. So in this way minus s option is used to set the date. Now I will reset my system date using again minus s option. So for that I will write our today's date, that is AUG 17 and current time 04:014:55. After that IST 2020. So this will set the date. So if I will execute the command date, so my today's date is set. So in this way, for setting the date, we must be in the super user. So I will first exit from here, super user, so that I will be at SRB user. Now we can execute our date command using various formats that we have seen our PPT. Okay, so for that I will use the format option. So for that we will write first plus percent, let us say small a. So this will give me the abbreviated weekday. So abbreviated weekday, today is Monday, so MON is displayed. Suppose capital A, this will give me the full name of the day. Now suppose the month name I want, so this will give abbreviated month name. So August is there, so AUG will be displayed. Now suppose I want the full month name, so I will write the capital B, so August is displayed. Now suppose I want to check the day of the month, so for that I will use small d option. This will give me the day of the month, so current day of the month is 17. So suppose I want to check the hour, so I will give the capital H. This will give the capital R of the current R, that is 4. After that I will use the option capital J. This will give the day of the year. So today is the 230th day of the year from the 1st January. Now suppose I want to check the month number. For that I will write small m. So August is the 8th month, so 8 is displayed. Now suppose I want to check the minutes, so capital M, so 16 minutes are there after 4 o'clock. Now suppose I want to check the day of the week, whether it is what is it, so I will write here small u. So Monday is the 1st, so 1 is displayed. Suppose I will use a W option, the day will start from 0 as a Sunday, so again Monday as a 1 will be displayed. After that I will use small y option, so this will give us 2020, last 2 digit, and if I will give capital Y, this will give the 4 digit of the year. Now we will execute the cal command. So just write the cal command, it will give us the calendar of the current month. So we can have various option of cal. Cal minus 1 will give us the calendar of the current month. Suppose we want the calendar of previous, current and next month, for that we will have cal minus 3 option. So it will display the calendar of July, August and the September. So the current month is August, so previous month is July and the next month is September. So the calendar of 3 months is displayed. Now suppose I want to display the starting of the calendar as a Sunday. Here by default it is Sunday. Suppose I want to change it as a Monday. For that I will have cal minus m. So this option will start the day of the week as a Monday. Now when I have executed only calendar, it is the day starting by Sunday. And if I will write here minus m option, it will start by M, Monday. Okay, now suppose I want the starting of the week as a Sunday, so minus S option can be used. By default is a starting as a Sunday. Now suppose I want to display the Julian dates, for that I will have the option cal minus J. So it will display the Julian calendar, that is the current month calendar with the Julian dates, that is the date starting from the 1st January. Now suppose you want to check the calendar of the August 2002. For that I will write August and 2022. So this will give me the calendar of 2022 August. Now suppose I want to check the calendar of previous year, for the month of April, for that 2019, that is 2019. So this will give us the calendar of April 2019. So in this way we can use our calendar command to display the calendar of any required month. Okay, now we are having another command, clear command, which will use to clear the screen. So here this previous content of the command execution are cleared. Now I will execute the next command tty, which will give me the terminal teletype name. That is, in Unix our terminal, to handling our terminal there is one file, so the name of that file is displayed here. That is the terminal file name. It is stored in the dev directory, dev directory. So this will give us the terminal file name. After that there is one interesting command, that is the script command. So this script command, suppose I will not give the name to this particular command, so after this they will give us the message that script is started. Now suppose I will write the cal command, so this will give us the calendar of current month. Now suppose the next command is date command, this will give me date. Okay, now suppose I will use the date plus my clock is showing percent R percent M minutes and percent S seconds. So I have written this. So date, my clock is showing percentage, percent M, percent S. So this will give me in this way output. Suppose I will stop my script, for that I will write down exit. So it will be stopping the script. Now suppose I will this particular file type script name file is created, and I want to display that TypeScript file. So this will give me the content of the TypeScript file. You can also give the name of your name to the file. For that you are required to write script. Let us say file name is the file 1. Okay, so file 1 script is started. Suppose I will write here cal command. You can write any command. So suppose again exit. So to display that particular file 1, so we are having the content of file 1. Okay, so in this way script command is used to record the our login session. Man command is there to check the help for any command. Let us say man cal, so this will give us the help for calendar. So all option of the cal command will be displayed. So we can scroll down to this with the arrow key, and to get out of this particular you can use Q. Okay, so man command will give us here. I will execute the who command. This will display the number of user who have been currently logged in. So this is the first user, root user. This is the another user, tycm-ss1, and this is the third user, srb user, which is my current user, which is working. Okay, so we will execute our first option of the who command, that is who minus a. This will display all the processes which are working from the various users currently. So these are the all processes which are executed. I will execute the next option, that is who minus b, which will give me the system last boot time. Okay, now the next option is who minus d, which will display all the dead processes. The next option is who minus H, capital H is there. So it will display the heading for all the commands, all the columns of the who command output. Okay, so here is the name of the first column, that is the first column heading. Second column heading is line, after that time, and after that the comments. So the next command is who minus L option. So this will give us all the login processes. And the last one, who am I? So this will give me what is the current user with which I have been logged into the system. Okay, so this is a who command is used to see how many users are currently logging into the system. Now there is another command, login command. Actually this command is not executed from all the system. So let us try here. So this is my one user, and its password I will enter here. So it will give us a login incorrect. If again I will enter, actually I am entering correct password, but it is showing that login is incorrect. So this version of the Linux is not supporting this particular command. Now I will execute the command passwd, which is used to change the current password. So it will give me information that changing the password for user SRB. So means I want to change the SRB user password. So here first I have to enter the current password of the SRB user. So I will enter it. So it will ask me for the new password. So I have entered it, and it is giving me that it is the bad password. It is based on the dictionary word. So I will try the another password. Again, bad password. So it asks for retyping the new password. So my password is updated here. So passwd command is used to change the password. Next command is su command. This command is used to get the or acquire the super user privileges. Here I need to type the root user password, because root user is the super user. So I will type here the root user. So from here you can see that this is the root user login. So all the facilities that are provided for the super user will be now applicable from this user. So from here we can execute all that commands. Now from here you can check that this is the hash prompt, which is the prompt of the super user, and this is the dollar prompt, which is the prompt of normal user. So all the super user commands can be executed from this prompt now. So we can execute that. So to come out of all the this super user, we can type the exit command, which is exiting from the super user login. So we are at now at normal user login. Now here the next command is pwd, that is the present working directory. Now this is my the present working directory, home SRB. Now suppose I will enter into any of the directory, let us say kkwp. So and I will print here pwd command. So this current directory is now kkwp. So in this way pwd command is used to display the present working directory.
Hello friends, welcome to course Linux Essential Commands. In this section we will study process commands. These are the commands which are related to process. So we will see first command, process status, that is PS. This command will display the characteristics of a process. For example, terminal number, time required for the execution of the process, process identification number, and command name. Syntax is PS option. PS command has first option minus F. This will give us the full listing showing PPID of each process. PS minus U, username, will display the processes of the user whose name is specified. PS minus A will display the processes of all users. PS minus E will display the processes including the user and the system processes. Next command is wait. This command allows wait until all the background processes are completed and then exit. Syntax is wait. Slip. This command is used to execute the commands after certain amount of time by slipping for a given seconds. Syntax is slip and the time. For example, slip train and PS. So with this, PS command will be executed after 10 seconds. Next command is exit. This command is used to quit the shell. Syntax is exit. So this is all about the process commands. Now in our next lecture, we will see how these commands are executed in Linux terminal. Thank you.
Here I have done the login with the SRB user. Now I will just reissue the command PS. So this will give me the first column as the PID, that is process identification number. This identification number is given by the operating system to that particular process. So the first process name is the bash process. So the first process name is the batch process, and the terminal name, it is showing the terminal name is the name of the terminal from where this command is executed and the time for which the process is executed. Okay, so bash is the name of the shell from where we are executing this command, and the ID of that bash is 3849, and we have issued the command PS, so it is there. Okay, so we will have the next command ps-f. This is executing and giving us the full listing of the process command with the parent process identification number. Now the bash parent of the bash process is the Linux root. Okay, so it is giving the PPID of that process, and PPID of the PS-F is the bash. So the bash ID will be here in the command line of the PS-F option. Okay, now we will have the next command with the next option, that is PSU. This will give the detailed listing of the processes of the users, and if we have the PS-U SRB, this will give me the processes that are executed by the user SRB. Okay, now we will have the PS command with minus A option. So this is the PS command which will give us the only the user processes. Okay, and if we want to check the system processes also, at that time we will give the minus E option. So from here you can see that there are many system processes executed and some user processes are there, that is the bash and PS. These are the two user processes. Okay, so this is all about the PS command. Now we will have the slip command. Slip command is creating the slipping the your system. So slip, now here I will perform the sleep for 10 seconds and after that the PS. So from here you can check that the PS command will be executed after 10 seconds. Okay, so we will get the output after 10 seconds. Also we can have the PS command, sleep command, along with the any other command. So sleep, suppose 15, you can take any delay, any time you can write there, that much time it will wait. So I will write the next command, date command. So date command will be executed after 15 seconds. So we will get the output. So we got the output. Now suppose we have the echo command, echo dollar dollar, this will give us the PID of the root user. Okay, after that we can execute our exit command. This will exit our login shell. Now suppose I will click this, this will exit.
Hello friends, welcome to course Linux Essential Command. In this section, we will learn file and directory manipulation commands. These are some file and directory manipulation commands. First command is cat command. It is used to create the file and display the contents of the file. Syntax is cat greater than sample. Sample is the name of the file that we want to create. After that, we will write the content that we want to store into the file. And we will save the content into the file with Ctrl D. After that, we will be at the prompt of the shell. Now, the same command, cat command, is used to display the content of the file. For that, we will write the syntax cat sample. So, this will display the content of sample file. We can specify multiple file name for displaying the content in the cat command also. Next command is ls command. It is used to list the files in the current working directory. Syntax is ls option. Ls command has various options like minus a. This will list all the files including the hidden files starting with a dot. Minus d. This will display the list of directories. Minus I will list the file's inode index number. And minus l. This will list the long format showing all user permissions. Next command is rm command. It is used to remove the file. Syntax is rm file name. Rm minus I option will make the command interactive. It will ask before removing the file. If user will enter yes, then that specified file will be deleted. Next command is mv command. It is used to move a file from one location to another. MV command can also be used to rename the file. Syntax is MV option source file name and destination file name. For example, MV abc.txt aa.txt. To rename the file abc.txt, we will use this command. Minus I option of the MV command will make the MV command interactive. It will ask for the confirmation for moving the file. Next command is cp command. It is used to copy a file to destination file. If the second file does not exist, then first it will create the file and then content will be copied to the file. But if it exists, then it will simply overwrite without any warning. Syntax is cp source file name and destination file name. Next command is join. It is used for joining the lines of two files on the basis of common field in each file called as key. Syntax is join option file 1 and file 2. Now file 1 and file 2 must have one common column in both the file. It is called as a key column. Next command is split. It is used to split the large file into smaller files. Default size is 1000 lines per file. Syntax is split minus n file name tag name. Minus n will specify the number of lines in each smaller file that we want to store. Tag name. By default, the split command will give the output in the file named as xaa, xab, xac. and if the tag name is specified, it will replace the X with that tag name. So the next command is head command. It is used to read the first 10 lines of the file. By default, 10 lines will be displayed. Now the number of lines to be displayed may be specified in the head command with minus n option. So this will specify the number of lines that we want to display in the head command. Next, tail command. It is used to print the last few number of lines of the file. Syntax is tail plus or minus n lbc file name. Now when we are specifying plus n, it will display all the lines starting from the nth line. And if we will specify minus n, it will display n lines from the end of the file. If we will write L, it will indicate the lines. B will indicate blocks and C will indicate characters. Next command is touch. It is the easiest way to create new empty file. Syntax is touch file name. Next command is mkdir. It is used to create a new directory in the current directory. Syntax is mkdir directory name. Cd command. It is used to change the directory. We can use it to change to any directory by specifying a valid absolute or relative path. Syntax is cd directory name. Next command is rmdir. It is used to delete or remove a directory. If the parent directory is having subdirectories, then first all subdirectories will be deleted and then the parent directory will be deleted. Syntax is rmdir directory name. Next command is diff. This command is used to show the difference between two text files. It also tells which line in one has to be changed to make two files identical. Syntax is diff file name 1, file name 2. If there is A which will specify, add the text to the file. C will make changes to be made in the file and D will delete the lines. This will indicate in the output. Now this is for making the two files identical. If there is less than sign means lines from the first file to be modified, and if there is greater than, then the lines from the second files needs to be updated. The next command is comm command. This command compares two sorted files. It compares each line of the first file with its corresponding line in the second file and generate three column output. The first column will list the lines only in the first file, second column will list the lines only in the second file, and third column will list the lines from both the files. Syntax is comm file name 1, file name 2. Next command is cmp. This command is used to compare files. It uses two file names as an argument and display the difference on the terminal. Syntax is cmp file name 1, file name 2. PR command. This convert the text file for printing. The PR command does minor formatting of the files on the terminal screen or for printing. It does not modify the original file. Syntax is PR file name. Next command is chmod. It is used to change or set the three permissions, read, write, execute, for all three categories of user. The types of users are user. User can also be called as owner, group, and other. Chmod can be operated in two ways: symbolic or alphabetical notation and octal or absolute notation. First we will see symbolic or alphabetical notation. Here we require to write symbols. First we will check what are the symbols. U, this is the symbol which is used to indicate owner of the file or directory. G is the member of the group belonging to the user. O, all other system user. A will specify all the user. So this is the user category. After that we are having permissions. There are three types of permission: read, write, execute. So R is used to assign read permission, W to assign write permission, X to assign or remove execute permission. Operations that we can perform: plus for assigning the permission, minus for removing the permission, and equal to will assign absolute permission. Syntax is chmod category operation permission filename. For example, chmod ugo plus x abc. This will assign execute permission for user, group and other. Next, octal or absolute notation. This method uses a number to specify each set of permission for the file. It assigns permission in 3 digits. First digit for owner, second digit for group, and third digit for other. Digit range is from 0 to 7. So, if there is number 0 means no permission, 1 means execute permission, 2 means write permission, 4 means read permission, 5 means read and execute permission, 6 means read and write permission, and 7 means all permission. Syntax is chmod 3 digit octal number and file name. For example, chmod 750abc will assign all permission to the user, read and write permission for a group user, and no permission to other. So friends, this is all about the various commands of file and directory manipulation. In our next lecture, we will see how these commands are executed in Linux. For that, enjoy the course. Thank you.
We'll create a new file cat greater than abc and type the content that we want to store into the file. So these are the contents of my file. To save this content, I will use Ctrl D so that I will get this prompt. Now, to display the content of the file, I will simply write cat abc. So these are the contents of the file. Now we will execute ls command. This will display all the files and folders which are present in the current working directory. The directory is displayed as a blue color. We will use minus a option, which will display all the hidden files along with the normal regular files. Hidden files are indicated by the dot. So ls minus d option will display the root directory file of the SRB user. Now we will have the ls minus I option. So this will display inode number of all files along with their name. These inode numbers are given by the system to file when it is created. Ls minus l option will give the long listing of the file, which will provide the permissions of that file. So normal file will be given by the dash and the directory file will be start by the D. The first three characters will show the permission of the user, after that group user and the other user. Read, write, execute, these are the three permissions. After that, the login user and the size of the file and the when that file is created, and the name of the file will be displayed. Now we will have various wildcard character with the ls command. Suppose ls question mark question mark. So this will display the files which is of two characters only. So all the file names which are having two characters will be displayed. Now suppose the n star, ls n star, that is the star, all the files starting with the n will be displayed. So star indicate any number of character after the n. So all that file will be displayed. Rm command, which is used to remove the file. Suppose rm and the name of the file. Suppose we will remove the pqr file, so it will delete that file. We will use ls command to check it. So here pqr is not there, means the file is deleted. Now suppose we want to make it interactive. For that I will use the minus I option and write the name of the file. So it will ask us whether to remove the regular file abc. If we will say no, it will not be removing the abc file. Check, it is not removed the file. Now suppose we will enter the s, at that time it will remove that file. See, with ls command we will check it. So abc file is removed. So minus I option makes it interactive. Same way, mv command, which is used to rename the file, the content will not get changed, only the name of the file will get changed. So we are having the file cm, so we will move it to the name cm department. So if we will check ls, it will not have the ls command. Mv command can be interactive with the minus I option. So cm department, in here we have to give the already existing file, suppose f1. Now it will ask whether to override it. We will say no, it will not override it. Cp command is used to copy the content of cm department to the cm file. It gives the content of the cm department will be copied. So there will be two files, cm and cm department. Now we will see the content of first file kkwp1 with the cat command. We are having another file num1 and num2. So it will display the content of num2. Cat num3 will display the content of file num3. Now we will execute the join command. The join command is used to join the content of two different files using a common field that is called as key field. So here the key field is the first column. So the content of the first file num1 and num2 are combined and the first column is common, so it will be displayed, and after that the other columns will be displayed. Now here we are having -1 option, which indicates that join the two files num1 and num2 on the key field of the first file. So -1 will give the key field of the first file, that is, and only one is given, that is the first column. Here the second file, so we will write the -2 to join the second file on the first column and the two file names. So here we have joined the two content of the two files. Now I have one file, long file, which is of size greater. We can use our split command on this particular file. So the content of the long file are as shown here. So I will use the split command. So -3 option I will use, so that each subfile will have 3 lines in it. Here I will use the tagline KKW, so that all subfiles will start by the name KKW. Okay, so ls command. So from here you can see that KKWAAAB, KKWAC, KKWAD and KKWAE. Now I will display the KKWAA. So it will have the content of the first line of that long file. Now the next 3 line will be stored into the KKWAB file. So in this way, subfiles are created by storing the 3 lines of the long file into the subfiles. We can have another lines also, for that we are required to specify that number. So we can have head command. Head is used to display the starting lines of the file. So how much lines that we need to display, that we have to specify in the form of option, like -5 and the long file name. So this will display the first 5 lines of the long file. Tail command is used to display the last line of the file. So -5, the option will display the last 5 line of the file. And tail plus 5 will display the lines from the 5th line of the long file. So it will display all the lines from the 5th line of the long file. So these are the uses of head and tail command. Now we will create an empty file using touch command. So touch abc. So this file is created. We can check it with the ls command. So file is created. We will see the content of that file using cat command. So cat abc. So the file is not having any content. It will not display anything. So touch command is used to create the empty file. So here we will see the redirection operator of the file. So the cat command is used to redirect the file. So these are the contents of F1 file and F2 file. Now I want to store the output of one command to the one file, another file. Okay. So the output of first command, that is the ls command, that I will store into the third file. So ls redirection. Here greater than is the redirection operator, and out.txt is the name of my new file. So I will check the content of out.txt using the cat command. So the output of the ls command, that is all the current directory files and folder names, will be stored into the out.txt file. Also the ls-l command output can be stored to the file pqr.txt. So long listing of the ls command will be stored into the file that we can see using the cat command. So cat pqr.txt will give the content of the ls-l command. So in this way we can redirect the output of one command to the another command. Okay. So cat command can also be used to combine the content of two files. Okay. So suppose here we are having two files, F1 and F2, and we want to combine the content of both of these files, that is F1 cat F1 space F2. We will write here cat F1 space F2 greater than out.txt. So the content of first file and after that the content of the second file will be stored into the out.txt file. So these are the contents of out.txt file. So in this way we can combine the content of two file into the third file. Now the cat command can also be used to append the content of one file to the another file. Here cat F1 first file greater than, this is the append operator F2. Now suppose we will see the content of F2, it is appended by the content of F1 and the content of F1 not get change. So these are the all commands that we have. So we will use putty. Here I have done my login SRP and these are the this is the output of ls command, which will show the list of files and directory which are present in the SRB home directory. So I will create here one directory, mkdir nasip. So directory nasip will be created. Now from here the output, you can see that the nasip directory is created. Now I will create some more directories, mkdir a1, a2 and a3. So three directories can be created at a time simultaneously, a1, a2, a3. So we can create multiple directories also. Now we can change our working directory to nasip. Okay, so suppose I will use pwd command. So the home srb, and in that I am in now nasip directory. So ls. Now as the content of nasip directory are not there, so the output of ls will be nothing. So I will be out of nasip directory using cd dot dot command. Ls command output is giving the directories and files of the SRB. Again I will enter into the nasip directory and create there one more directory, abc. Now I will list it, so it will display it as a ABC. So we have created ABC in the nasip directory. Now we can also enter into ABC. If I will use pwd, it will give me the current working directory path, that is in nasip. Again there will be ABC. So now I am in ABC directory. So I will be out of ABC using cd dot dot command. Now suppose I want to remove that particular directory nasik. So it will give me error because nasik is having only one directory ABC. It is not finding it. So I will be out of nasik first and I will use rmdir nasik. Now it will give me message that directory is not empty because ABC directory is there. So we need to first delete the ABC directory. For that we will enter into the nasik directory. So cd nasik. So I will be in nasik directory. Now from here I will remove first ABC directory. So rm abc. So I will be now out of nasik directory and now I will be able to remove the nasik directory using rmdir command. So first I will list down that nasik is there. Now I will use rmdir nasik so that it nasik directory will be removed. So rmdir nasik will remove that particular directory. So now see, from this output you can check that nasik directory is removed from the SRB home directory. Now I will clear first screen. Now we will execute the further command. For that first check how many files are there in our SRB user. So these are the files and folders in our SRB user. So I will display the file 1. The content of file 1 is apple, banana, mango and orange. Now file 2. Contents are apple, banana, orange, papaya. Now file 3, apple, banana, mango. And now file 4, apple, banana, mango, orange and Z. Now I have created this file like this, cat file 5. And I have typed the list of the fruits, apple, banana, mango. And use Ctrl D to come out of that file. Now from this I will execute the diff command, diff file 1 and file 2. So it has given me output that 3D2 means delete third line from the first file. Okay, so we need to delete the third line because it is not there in the file 2. And also it is saying that add the line 4 papaya into the file 1. So as the papaya is not there in the file 1, so it has given add the line 4 into the file 1. Okay. So in this way diff command is giving us what type of line we should add or remove. So for adding it will give A and for deleting give T. So again I will execute diff command on file 1 and file 3. It will give me the output as 4D3. So from these two files the word orange is should be deleted from the first file so that both the files will become identical. So the word orange is at line number 4. So it should be deleted. So again I will use diff command for another two files. File 3 and 4. Now it is saying that add two lines, line number 4 and 5 into the file, that is orange and zip. So with these two lines should be added into the file. Now suppose I will write the command in a reverse way, that is diff file 4 and 3. It will say that delete the line 4 and 5 from the file. Okay. Now we will see the next command. For that first check the cat file 1 and file 2 again. So these are the contents of our file 1 and 2. Now I will use comm command. For the execution of this comm command, the contents of the file must be in sorted order. So both the files are sorted. So first we got the three column output. First column will give the lines which are there in first file only. Second column will give the lines which are in the second file, and third column will give the lines which are common to both the files. So we will try the CUMM command for the other files, file 1 and file 4. So third column we got the 4 lines common in both the file and only the one line which is there in file 4, 0. Okay. So CUMM command gives us 3 column outputs. The necessary condition is both the files must be sorted. Now the next command is CMP file 1 and file 2, which will give what is the difference between the two specified files. So it gives the line number and the byte number where there is the difference between the two files occur. So now we will execute some more commands. We are having the PR command. The PR command is used to make the content of the file ready for printing. So original file of the specified file will not get changed. It will just make the page ready for printing. Okay. Now we will search another long file. This long file has so much characters. So we will use our PR command for this long file. So it has displayed the content of the long file and make the page ready for printing. So it will not affect the original content of the file. The next command is chmod command. For that we will use the option minus L, which will list all the permission which are there for the file. So here we are having the dash character for the regular file. Now here Sheetal file is there, which is having all 3 permission. We can change these permissions using chmod command. So read, write, execute permission for all 3 types of user. So suppose UGO and I want to remove all these 3 permissions. So I have used minus RWX and the name of the file. So we will check our answer using ls minus l and Sheetal. So that it has displayed that there is no permission to the any type of user, okay, for the file Sheetal. Now I will again use chmod command and will assign read permission to the user for the file Sheetal. Again I will use ls minus l command. It will display the that read permission is assigned to the user. Now again I will use my chmod command to assign some more permission to the file Sheetal. So UGO RWX, let us say all 3 permissions are assigned to the Sheetal. So ls minus l will display all the permissions are assigned to the Sheetal file. Okay, so this will display all the permissions are assigned. So this is our output. We got it. And its color is also changed. The name of the file color is changed because it has the execute permission. So the next one is again we will use our chmod command. So UGO, suppose I will remove the execute permission of the Sheetal so that there will not be execute permission for all 3 types of user. Now again its file color will get changed because the execute permission we have remove. So it will display in normal color now because it has not the execute permission. See, it is in white color. So we have removed the execute permission. So in Linux, the executable file is displayed in the green color. So we are having another method of the chmod, that is the absolute method. Here we will specify the number for the permissions. So I will use the chmod and I will give 3 zeros, means that no permission for the file Sheetal. So for any of the type of user, okay, so no user is having no permission. So ls minus l Sheetal, with this we will get that all the 3 type of user are not having any type of permission. So all the permissions are removed using 000. So again I will use chmod and I will use 750 Shetal. First 7 will indicate that all permission will be there for the user. 5 means it will display that read and execute permission is assigned to the group. And 0 means no permission is assigned to the other. Now, so see from here you can check that all permissions are there for the normal user and read and execute permission for the group and no permission for the other. So we can also have another file. So suppose spell file. So I want to give write permission to the other for the spell file. So we will check the permissions of the spell file using ls-l. So write permission is assigned to the other of the spell file. Okay. Now again we will assign some permission to the spell file using absolute mode. So for that I will specify the number 540 and the name of the file. Now here first 5 means that read and execute permission to the user, 4 means only read permission to the group and no permission to the other. Okay, so 540 will specify this. So I think here we should stop.
Hello friends, welcome to course Linux Essential Commands. In this section we will learn text processing commands. These are some text processing commands. First command is TR command. It is the abbreviation of translate or transliterate, indicating its operation of replacing or removing specific characters in its input data set. Syntax is TR option set 1 set 2. If option is not specified, the values of set 1 will get replaced by the values of set 2. If we will use minus T option, it will delete the characters in set 1. It will not translate. Minus S option will replace each input sequence of a repeated character that is listed in set 1 with a single occurrence of that character. Next command is WC command, that is word count command. It is used to find out the number of lines, words, character in a file. Syntax is WC option file name. The file name which is specified in this command, that file, lines, words and character will get counted. If we will write minus L option, it will print new line counts. For minus W, it will print the word counts. Minus C option will print byte counts. Minus L, capital L, will print the length of the longest line. And minus M will print the character counts. Next command is cut command. It is used to copy columns to the standard output file. It is used to cut the portion of the file vertically. Syntax is cut file name. Suppose this file name, specified file name column, I want to cut and put into the another file. At that time we can use this cut command. With minus F option, it will print only these field names that we have specified, and minus C option will select only the characters that we have specified. Paste command. This command is used to join the files horizontally by the outputting the lines consisting of the lines from each file specified and separated by the tab as a delimiter. Syntax is paste option files. So it will paste the values of the various files. Next command is spell. It is the spell checking program which scan a text file for misspelled words and print each misspelled word on its own line. Syntax is spell option file name. Sort command. This command is used to sort a file. Syntax is sort option file name. If we will not specify option, the given file name file will get sorted. With minus O option, it will write the output in the another file. Minus N option will sort the file numerically, and minus R option will sort the file in reverse order. Next command is grep command. It is used to search a pattern or word inside a file. Syntax is grep option pattern file name. minus c will display the count of the number of occurrences of the pattern. Minus l will display the list of file names which contains the pattern. And minus n will display the line number along with the lines containing the pattern. Next command is more command. If the file is too large for its content to fit in one screen, it will scroll off your screen. So we will use more command to display the file contents page wise. Syntax is more option file name. So friends, this is all about our text processing commands. In our next lecture, we will see how these commands are executed in Linux. Thank you.
So first we will use the tr command. For that we are having one file abc. So first I will show you the content of this file abc. Now we will use our tr command to translate the content of this file to the uppercase. And we will redirect the input for this command using the redirection operator, input redirection operator. So we will get the content of the file to be translated into uppercase. We can also use another way to translate all the lower case letter into the uppercase using the A to Z character. This will also require the input redirection. Actually, this command will not change the content of file. It will just display the translated output in the uppercase. Now suppose we want to replace any particular character with the other character. For that also we will require this tr command. So for this, let us say kk, I want to translate it into uppercase only. So only kk, this particular character, I want to be translated into uppercase. So this will translate the lowercase kk into the uppercase. You can also replace this kk with the other character. So that can also be change. Okay, now we will see another option for the tr command. Minus s option of the tr command is used to squeeze the character. So I have one file occur which will have some repeated character. So I will remove the spaces. For that I will write tr minus s and the space that I want to remove and the name of the file using input redirection operator. So the space are reduced. Now suppose I want to reduce the characters also, only one occurrence I want. So I will use in this way. I can also store the output of this command into the another file. Let us say out file. So we will check the out file contents. So we will get the content of the out file. So in this way, tr command is used to reduce the occurrences of the character and also to replace the character. Now we will execute our next command, that is the cut command. For that we will see first the content of some file. Sample cut is the name of my file. So these are the contents of sample cut. And I have one more file, sample cut 1 and sample cut 2. Now suppose I will use here the command cut command with a minus f option. Minus f option is used to specify the name of the field. Now suppose for the sample cut one file, I want to display only the column number 1 and 3. So I will write here the name of the file. So it will display me the only the first column and the third column. I can also add here some more column by specifying comma and the number of the column. So fourth column is also added here. We can also use minus c option for cut command. So this minus c option cut the column character wise. Let us execute this command on the sample cut file. Here the number of characters are there. We can cut some particular character. Let us say I want to cut the character 1 and 3 for the sample cut file. So here it is displaying only the first and the third character of the file. So in this way, cut command vertically cut the content of the file. Next command we are having is the paste command, which is used to paste the content of the two file. Let us say two files are sample cut 1 and sample cut 2. So it will paste the column of the sample cut 1 file first, and after that the sample cut file, cut 2 file. So it will paste both file columns side by side, that is vertically. Okay, so the next command is spell command. This particular spell command is used to check the spelling of the file. Let us say we are having one file, spell file. So it will show you the spelling mistake. I will first display the content of spell file. So here is the spelling mistake. So it has displayed that. It will display in which word it is having the spelling mistake. So the next file we will have spell. The next file name is spell1. So here I will show you the content of file first. So this is the Amit here. Now Amit is this is not a dictionary word. So it has displayed it as a spelling mistake. So the next command is sort command. This command is used to sort the file. So let us sort the sample cut file, sample cut 1 file. So it has arranged the sample cut file content in increasing order. We can sort this file in reverse order also. So let us use the option minus R for that. So this will sort the file in reverse order. Now suppose I want to store this particular output in some other file. For that I am having the option minus O. So sort minus O and sample cut. First I will require to specify here the output file name. So my output file name is output, and the name of the file on which the sort operation is needed to be completed. So we will check the content of output file. This file, output file, will be created with this command. It's not required to create before the execution of the command. It will be automatically creating that output file. So the sorted file content of the sample cut 1 file will be stored into the output file. Next command is grep command, which is used to search a particular pattern. For that we are having two files that we will see first, gr1 and gr2. These are the contents of file gr1 and gr2. Now we want to search some particular pattern using grep command. Let us say grep And here we will use option minus C, which is displaying the count of number of the occurrences of the pattern. So I will write here GR1, so it will give me actually I need to specify here pattern also. So I will write that grep command again, minus C, pattern is cmdept and the name of the file is gr1, so it will give me the occurrences of the how many time that pattern is there in the file. The next option is minus L, which will specify the line where that pattern is present. So this will give us the list of the file which is having this particular pattern. So we can also combine this particular both options. So here we got that gr1, we will add here one more file name, that is gr2. So first we will execute minus L option again. So it will give us the list of the file which is having the pattern, and we will use the minus C option here, which will give us the name of the file and how much time that particular pattern is there. So GR1 file is having 4 times the cmdept pattern and GR2 is having 1 time the pattern. So these two options can combinely use and will give us in output in this way, that is the list of the file which is having the pattern. We are having the another option, that is the minus N, which will give us the number along with the lines containing the pattern. So this is the line number along with the file name and the pattern. So the last command is the more command. This more command is used to see the content of long file. Here first I will display this long file content, so it will scroll up the content of the file. As the file is of more size, it will just display the last line of the file. Suppose I want to see the content of the file page wise, at that time I will use this more option and will specify the name of the file, more long file. So it will display me the page wise content of the file. So with this we can easily see the content of the file.